In this video, I'm going to be giving you an overview of Yammer and the ways you can use it in your organisation. Yammer is a great tool for keeping people in your organisation up to date with all the latest news internally and externally as well. It's also a great way to ask for opinions, you can do polls, questionnaires and things like that. So let's get started. So when you log into your Yammer, you are part of a network. So right now I am on the Breakwater IT Yammer network. You'll be loaded onto your home feed, which shows you content that they think is relevant or most recent posts or posts which recently had engagement. So, for example, people commented or liked them. You can change this. So if you hover over your home feed, you can choose to discover new content only, or you can see all conversations in your network. Below your home feed, you have your inbox. So when someone directly replies to a post you've made or tags you in a comment, this will flag up here. You can also send private messages to other people within your network. Below your inbox, you have communities. So as I said, at the moment I am on the Breakwater IT Yammer network, but within that network there are communities. So you can see also just a bit further down, my communities are listed down here. But if we click into the communities button, it will take me to all communities within the network. So these ones down the left are ones I've joined. When I click on communities, it gives me the option to join some recommended ones that I'm not currently part of, or you can switch to all. So you can filter by the size of the community, you can filter by the date it was created or put them alphabetically. So here you can see these are kind of ones that I've already joined. If I scroll further down, there's a couple that I'm not currently part of, so I can join those communities if I want to. There's also a button up here to create a community as well. So you can create one entirely yourself, give it a name, description, and you can add people from your network to it. And it's worth noting that if you create the community, you are then the admin, but you can add other admins later on. Now below communities, we have favorites. It's pretty self-explanatory. You can favorite a community to make it easier to access. If it's one that you use quite a lot or that you maybe are an admin of, you might pop it in your favorites. There are two ways to add a community to your favorites. So you can either hover over in my communities and you'll see that the little people change to a heart. So you can press that. Or you can go into your community and you can see here, there's also a little heart there, which you can press to remove or add. And obviously below your favourites again, there's the selection of your communities that you're a part of. So if you want to access the ones that you're not a part of, use the communities button. Otherwise, your communities will be listed down the left-hand side. And again, you have the option to create one yourself down here too. Once you're in a community channel, again, on the feed, it'll be the most relevant or most recently engaged content. At the very top here, you have your community profile image and you have your cover photo. So these can only be updated by admins of the group. Below these, you'll have your title for your community. And then you've got a selection of tabs at the top here. So conversations is where you'll see the feed. So all the posts, the discussions, the questions, the polls that people put in. You've then got about. So about's a very interesting one. It gives you insights. So you can see how many people are active in the community, how many posts have been made in the last 28 days, and you can actually go on to see more to find out more about some of the insights they have. And then below that, you can see the members, so you can see who the admins are, who's a part of it. You can add or remove people as well from this. And then further down, you can add community information. So this is for admins only, to add basically a description of the community. And then related communities. So if you feel that marketing strongly relates to, example, Breakwater IT events, then you can select that and you can add it as a related community at the bottom there. Next up, you have the files tab. So this basically just covers all the files shared within that community. So any images that you have put in there, they'll all just basically be under this one files tab. And finally, you have events. So another thing you can do on Yammer is add events under your community. So if we had an upcoming event, let's say there was a big marketing meetup, you can pop that under events in the community and everyone will be able to see that. So next to the little favorites heart, which is going over to the right slightly, there's the three dots here. And this brings up some more options for you. So settings only applies to admins. Others won't see this. So this basically allows you to change the name of the community. It allows you to give it a description or change the description. You can also change the settings. So anyone in your network can view and join, or you can only add approved members. So you can have private communities where only certain people will be able to access them and others won't be able to join unless they're given permission or approved to join. And then your default publisher. So I'll go on to the different publishing options when you post on your feed, but you can choose to either publish a discussion or a question as the default. And of course, there's also the option to delete the community as well if you feel it's no longer needed. So next, back on those three dots, you've got mute community and feed. So that basically means that you'll stop seeing posts from that community in your home feed, but you don't necessarily have to leave it. So you can just access those posts by going into the community itself. Subscribe by email means that you'll get email notifications when someone posts in this channel. There will be a delay on sending the email. So if you read it on Yammer before the email alert is sent, then you won't get the email basically. Post by email. So clicking this gives you an email address and you can then email a post from Outlook and it will post it to Yammer. So you basically just put the email address in the toolbar and then it will send a post directly from your Outlook. And then the final option was just embed. So that gives you some embedding code to, if you want to put a community feed on your website or maybe embed it on a SharePoint page, then you can do that there. So then you have the section which allows you to post. So as mentioned in the setting, you can change the default posting to question if you're the community admin, but for this it is currently set to discussion. So discussion is just a text field. So if I click on there, you can see that. And you can start typing. So when you first start typing, it will type quite big, but then as you add more, it will be smaller. Below the text, you have add people. So this allows you to almost CC people into your post without actually tagging them in the content. But if you want to tag them in the copy, then you can just use the at symbol and then tag people that way. Below add people, you've then got the orange speech bubble. And this lets you change the type of post. So for example, you press discussion, but actually you think you could do a question, then you can just flick between that there. Before we do that, I'll just show you some of the other formatting options. So the megaphone changes your post to an announcement. This is useful to flag something important up as it notifies everyone in the community to the post, regardless of what email alert preferences they have. Everyone will get a notification about this specific post. So it is really good for like company-wide announcements. Next to this, you've got your traditional formatting options. So bold, italic. You can add a link, you can do some bullet points, things like that. You've then got topics. So topics isn't something we use here at Breakwater really at the moment, perhaps because our Yammer network is fairly small. But topics essentially lets you tag your post to a specific topic. So if I click on it, for example, you can tag Microsoft Azure as a topic. Okay, and then others in the network can then follow topics or search for posts with the specific topic tag. So if people search for Microsoft Azure, they would then find this post here. You can then also attach things. So you can attach files, PDFs, Word documents, things like that. And you can add GIFs, something we absolutely love here at Breakwater. I'm sure there will have been posts come up with GIFs in this demo. And once you're happy, you can then hit the post button and that will post your content. So you can obviously, as I said, you can either switch to a different type here, or if you don't want to send your post, you can press the little cross up here. So next you have question, just as it sounds, you can ask a question and it will show up in a bit more of a nicer format than just your standard text field. After that, you had praise. So it's a nice way to recognize a colleague and give them some praise publicly. You can change this little thumb icon at the top to reflect what you're giving praise for. You can tag the person that you want to praise and then share what they've done. Again, just a nicer format than a standard text field. And then finally, you have poll. So that allows you to poll people. You type in your question and you add your answer choices. If you add answers to all three, you will then get a fourth and so on. So you're not limited to just the three answers. And again, with all of these options, you have the same formatting. You can make them announcements. You can add text formatting, topics, GIFs, etc. So you can see below here, we've got a discussion post just about some new Breakwater merchandise that we added. And you can see we've got some comments down here. So you can write a comment. It will just be a text field, but you've got some of the same options. Again, you can add GIFs and files. You can CC people or you can tag them. With a comment, you can like a comment. So if you hover over the little thumb, you can either just click on it to give it a thumbs up, or you can give different reactions here. You can comment, so you can directly reply to someone, or you can share a comment, so share it to a private message or to another community. And then you can also delete that comment as well. And it's very similar options with the original post as well. So you can like, comment, and share that post into other networks. You can see who's liked the post there. And if we scroll up at the top of the post, so this was a post that I made. We've got the three dots here. And this allows you to do different things with that post. So you can look at insights, so who's engaged with it. You can edit the post if you made a mistake, or you can completely delete it. You can move it to another community. You can close the conversation, so if you don't want any more comments or feedback, then you can just stop that altogether. If you pin a conversation, it will put it right at the top of your community, so regardless of the algorithm of picking the most recent content, that will always be at the top of your community when you load it. You can copy a link, so you can send someone a link directly to this post. You can unfollow the post. That means you won't get any more notifications from people. So if people continue to comment, you won't be notified of that. View conversation just basically opens the post in another window so you can view it solo. Change to questions. So if you want to change it from a discussion to a question, you can easily do that there. And add topics. So if you've posted and you want to add some more topics to it, you can do that. So those are the posts. So then if we move over to the right here, we've got some more sections. So you've got members first. So again, you can see who the admins are. They've got these little stars. And then you can see other people. So you can click into this 25 and you'll get a full list of who's in the group. You can add or remove people. And that's a really handy thing because if, for example, you've made an all company group, you want everyone to be a part of that group, so you can add people to it. Below this, you've got the info section. So when we were looking at editing earlier, this is where kind of the summary of what the group is about would be. So if I go to our all company group, there is a nice little info summary here saying, welcome to the Breakwater IT community. And this info section here can only be changed by admins again. Also, you have pinned. So this is another great example. You can put documents on display that will always be there. So they're not just under the files tab. They are permanently on the right hand side of the group. Again, this can only be changed by the community admin. In our case, we've got some kind of admin guidelines for using Yammer. So let's go right to the top now and this very top bar, and I'm gonna go right to left instead. So SC, that's my initials. That allows you to sign out of Yammer. That allows you to view your account or view your office profile. The question mark next to it, that's just a help button. If you wanna get some help with Yammer, then you can use that. This kind of global icon is your notifications. So how many items you've got read. So as I said, we are currently in the Breakwater IT network, but I'm also part of an external network too. So this little tick here shows that I'm fully up to date with the Breakwater network, but I've missed quite a few posts in the tech data network. And you can also search for external networks here too. You then have the settings cog here. So edit settings will basically take you to things like your name, your contact details, your preferences, some more personal details. You then have manage delegate settings. So This is where you can basically give other people access to post on your behalf. There are two different roles, so you can either have someone post on your behalf, or you can have someone post on your behalf and add or remove other delegates to do that too. Okay. You then have manage desktop notifications. So this will allow you to switch on whether your browser can send you notifications while you're working, but obviously that does only work if you have your browser open. So you don't have to have Yammer open, but you have to have your browser open for those notifications to pop up. Skin tone for reactions is a good one. So you can choose your default skin tone. So when you go to like a post, you can either just keep it in a general, you know, a yellow thumbs up, or you can choose a skin tone for yourself, which is a really nice touch. Below this, you have themes. So at the moment, I'm in the standard office theme. But here, we also have an organisational theme set by our admins. So if I click on that, you'll see on the top left that the Yammer logo has switched to the Breakwater IT one. But there's a whole bunch of other kind of themes you can have. So you can have some cats up there. You can have some dots, some stars, whatever kind of thing you fancy. And then language and time zone, change your password are both pretty self-explanatory, just things you can do on there. So next to the cog, we have the smiley face, and that just allows you to give feedback to Microsoft on Yammer. Next to your smiley face, you've got your bell. So this is your notifications wall. Basically any reactions or tags or comments you get, they will all pop up in there. Next to the bell, you'll find this little switch with new Yammer. So currently we are on new Yammer, but if I slid that across, we'll just press it on now, you will switch to the old version of Yammer. It's up to you what you prefer, but I think the new version of Yammer looks a lot better. So we're gonna switch back up there. There we go. Okay, next we have the search bar. So if I'm on the home feed, for example, the search bar will look pretty normal. You can search for people, you can search for communities, you can search for topics. If I go back into marketing, you'll see there's an extra little drop down on the end here. So that means that you can search within the community, or if you're just on a community and you just want to search all of Yammer, you can swap that there. And lastly, along this top bar over on the left, you have your waffle icon. It is also your app launcher. This is the same on all Office on the Web applications. So it simply allows you to switch between the different apps. So you can switch between Outlook, Teams, Word, PowerPoint, whatever you need. Now to finish off, Yammer is absolutely lovely on the web. But when it comes to communication within the workplace, ideally you want everything to be in one place, right? So Yammer can also be accessed in Microsoft Teams. So I'm just going to open my version and there it is. Now within Microsoft Teams, it's actually called Communities. So if you go to your left and you want to find an app, you will want to look for Communities. So you can see it still has the Yammer logo. So it's still familiar, but it just goes under a different name within Teams. And you can see it looks exactly the same. So however you prefer to use Yammer, whether it's on a browser or in Teams, you get the same experience. Within Teams, you will only have the option to use new Yammer though. I personally find this better as I have Teams open all day, so I get Yammer notifications instantly as opposed to having to check it on the browser throughout the day. But it's down to your preference and how you work. And as I say, if you prefer the new Yammer over the old. So hopefully that gives you a good overview of Yammer, the kind of things you can do to keep your network up to date.